graph, you need to find the intersection. If it is a table, I will show you. Okay. Any other question? HS that you found here is the system curve. The curve or the characteristic of that particular system. Okay. To ensure that your pump and you, to ensure that your pump can work on that particular system, you need to find the correct operating point. Because otherwise, the pump will not work properly. Let's say, if you look at this graph, you want to operate the pump in here, but the system curve is over there. It will not work. As simple as that. Because the pump needs you to provide the head of, let's say, the pump, the system. In order the pump, for the pump to work for this system, the pump has to deliver the head of 6 meter if you want to deliver 0.6 meter per second. But you operate the pump at a different point. That's it. If you deliver at high flow rate, the head will not be sufficient to drag the flow. If you operate the pump at the lower flow rate, again you will not meet the requirement of the system. So either one is not working. Okay. So now HS is given in terms of a table, sorry, HP. So now you have your HS, right? You have your HS. You do the same calculation from here. Your HP is given by the manufacturer or the factory. So what you need to do now is just having a Q, HP, HS. Log. Or calculate. What is this? P Okay. If you realize for a pump, the higher the flow rate, the lower the head delivered. But for a system, the higher the flow rate, the higher the head required. Got it? Because the pump has limitation. Either you want to go for the free delivery, which is the maximum flow rate, or you go for the shut-off head, or the maximum head provided. You cannot go either way. Sorry, you cannot go both on a both way, only either one. But for a system, of course, the higher the flow rate, the higher the head is required. That is the system. Right. You either work leisurely, earn a little bit, or you work harder, earn a lot. If I ask you, of course you will ask, you will say, I will choose to work leisurely, but earn a lot. Okay, how to do that? Become son of your kids. Unfortunately, you are not. So, no choice for us. Right. The same goes for the pump. Either you got the highest maximum head at minimum flow rate, or you got the highest flow rate at minimum head. But for a system, okay, if you want to deliver more flow rate, you need to provide me more head. System, say that. Okay, so you need to keep the balance. You have to meet. If we plot that, or if you calculate that, you plug in here, let's say, I'm not doing it properly, but I will just look at that. You see that at zero, this one is 6.1, this one is 34.8. This is a shut off head, the maximum. If you don't know it, this is what we need. For a palm, as the floret increases, the head will decrease. But for the system, as the floret increases, the required head also increases. You see, until one point, you see here, 0568, this one is still higher than, sorry, this one is still higher than that. But suddenly, this one is higher than that. So you know the operating point will be between this and that. Right. So the operating point will be between this and that. So you reduce it, 0.7, you calculate. From here, 0.7, you calculate. If the value of this and this is equal, that is your operating point.
So,
unfortunately. Not really trial and error. It's kind of, you look at the trend. So you know, one way is using the graph, second is using the table, the third one is like in your tutorial. If you open the tutorial, the HP is given as equation. This one is the easiest way, because then you got your HS. You just need to put HS equal to HP. Do the calculation, then you get your Q. Okay, sometimes it is given in term of an equation like this. Is that clear? So three ways. The most painful one is if it is given in a graph. But unfortunately, in real life, that's it. That is what you have. When you work later on, when you open a catalog of a pump, it will not be given in this kind of equation. This equation is because your lecture is so nice. Just give you, okay, la, this one is the equation. Just do that. But in real life, what you get is this. In real life, this is what you will have. So you need to plot your characteristic curve there. When your characteristic curve is there, what will you do next? Huh? Ask your boss. Where do you want me to bring the, I mean, at what flow rate do you want me to drag the liquid? If, let's say, your system curve is like this, then your boss says you need to deliver 800 gallons per minute, then you need to find it. Okay? If it is like that, so you know you need to use the pump number 1, 2, 3, 4. And for the pump number 4, the efficiency will be around 78%. Okay? 78, no, less than that. Around, 78 or 76%. Okay? Now you know the pump that you want to order. You get the pump. Now by having 78%, you can calculate the required shaft input. Okay? Times that. You get the self-input. Let's say 24.5 kilowatt. Then you need to buy a motor that can drive the pump. Okay? So you will end up having two catalog. One is the pump catalog, and the other one is the system you need to draw in the catalog. The motor catalog. Okay? That one is still simple. We haven't touched what happen if you need to drive high flow rate, okay, using axial flow or centrifugal flow, axial pump or centrifugal pump or mixed pump. We haven't touched that. We just know, okay, this is it. This is the flow rate, this is the pump.